Hey everybody, my name's Matt, and I'm speaking to you on behalf of Expert Village.
All right, now I'm going to be talking to you a little more about automation. If you've got a track, you'll notice in the bottom left there's a plus sign. If you click that, it's going to bring down another dialog. And default is volume. If you keep going down, it'll bring up things like pan and mute and such things. I'm just gonna adjust the automation for the volume right now. If you go up to your line tool, I'm gonna go ahead and click sign, and you can draw in the volume. You can draw a little sine wave, and when you listen back to it, you'll notice that the drums went in and out. It's not a real smooth sine there. So if you want to go to File, go to Preferences, and click on Editing, you'll see a little slider bar here. To the right, it says Automatic Automation Reduction Level. Take that down to Minimum and click OK. And you'll notice that when you click to make the sine wave there, it'll adjust it and be a little more detailed. In the last lesson, we talked about the mixer. If you want to go ahead and go up to Devices and click Mixer to bring that back up, there's another way you can do automation. This is my drum track right here, so I'm going to go ahead and click the little R beside it to turn on Read Automation. And if you click the W, that's Write Automation. And I'm going to go ahead and click Play, and I'm going to adjust the volume as the song plays. And go ahead and click stop, and I'm going to unclick Write Automation. And when I go to play it back, you'll notice the slider going up and down. And you can also automate the pan here, using the exact same method. And the automation can be very useful, and you can automate a lot of different things in Cubase.